Hi everyone, I'm Emily, and today we are going over the science behind how soap reduces surface tension and how soap kills the coronavirus. For this one, you're going to need a cup of water, a coin, some soap. I'm using two knives here, but you could really just use two, like toothpicks or your finger or just whatever you have. Some wax paper, a plate with water in it, pepper, an orange, and some lollipops. We're gonna start with four surface tension demos and then we'll get to the coronavirus. For your first surface tension demo, you're gonna need your cup of water. Now the cool thing about water molecules is that they're all slightly attracted to each other. Kind of like they all wanna hold hands with each other. They all wanna be friends with each other. So if we look at our cup, the water molecules in the center, they have friends above them and beside them and below them and to their diagonal and every which way. So they have lots of different molecules to hold hands with. But look at the water molecules right at the surface. There's no water molecules above them, it's only air. So what happens is they hold on extra tight to the ones next to them and the ones below them, and they bunch up together real tight. This is what creates our surface tension. We can see this in action. You just want to add a few droplets to the top of your cup. I have this little syringe that I'm going to use. So that you can see that convex shape of water over the top of the cup. We can see that surface tension in action, but let's add soap. Soap is a surfactant, which means it reduces surface tension. See what happens when we don't add anything, we just touch the top like this. Nothing happens, it kind of just like bounces right off the top. When we add soap, 3, 2, 1, it spills all over the side. Now we can do our second demo with the coin. Add a bunch of drops to the top of the coin. You can really see that surface tension in action when you use a coin. That dome shape looks oh so beautiful. Now go to your wax paper and take your same syringe or whatever you're using and just add a few drops to your wax paper. Look at how they bead up like that. They're beading up like that because water molecules are more attracted to each other than they are the wax paper. Now we can take our knife that does not have any soap on it and just touch those little beads and see how it does nothing. It does nothing. But now let's take our knife with the soap on it and watch this. They spread out flat because we are breaking that surface tension. We're breaking the bonds between the water molecules and it spreads out over the wax paper. Okay, now go to your plate. Add some pepper to the top of your plate, just like so. And after you've done that, take your finger, just your finger, put your finger in the water. Nothing happens, right? Nothing happens. Now, put your finger in the soap. We now have a soapy surfactant finger. And put that right in the middle, 3, 2, 1. Look at the pepper. What happened here? Well, we broke the surface tension in the middle. The bonds between the water molecules is really weak in the middle, but those bonds are still intact along the circumference. They're still trying to hold on to the water molecules to their side and to the center. And so those pepper flakes are riding that wave out radially to the outer circumference where those bonds are still intact because those water bonds are still trying to pull at the center. But this demo doesn't really show us why soap is useful when washing our hands. It just shows us that it reduces the surface tension in water. More on that in a second. Now that we've done that, let's talk about coronavirus. Coronavirus is made up of a bit of material protected by an outer layer of fat and proteins. So we can think of this orange as our coronavirus and its peel as that outer layer of fat. Soap molecules are really interesting. Let's think of this lollipop as a soap molecule. On one end of the molecule is water-loving, it's hydrophilic. On the other end, it's water-fearing, hydrophobic, but it's also fat-loving, lipophilic, and hydrophobic. right? So when we throw soap in water, the hydrophobic end is trying to get as far away from that water as possible. And in doing so, it gets in between all of those molecule bonds that we talked about that create surface tension, all of those water molecules that are holding on to each other really tight. It's like a game of Red Rover, where all of the water molecules are holding on to each other really tight, and the soap molecules come running in between them and breaking those bonds. They wiggle in between those bonds and they break that surface tension. That's how soap reduces surface tension in a liquid. But what does soap do to the coronavirus? Well, this fat-loving end is very interested in that outer layer of fat in the coronavirus. And so what happens when we're washing our hands with soap, if we have the coronavirus on it, that fat-loving end of each of these molecules is tearing and ripping apart that outer layer of fat on our coronavirus. Now, once that happens, once that outer layer is taken away, all that bits and parts of the coronavirus are just absolutely annihilated. But that takes time, right? The CDC recommends that we wash our hands for 20 seconds to make sure that the soap has enough time to just annihilate those viruses. Now, the really interesting thing is, once the coronavirus is broken up into many pieces, these soap molecules form little prisons around them. The fat-loving end is trapping them inside in something called micelles. Here our soap molecules have trapped in those parts of the coronavirus, and then when we wash our hands with water, the water-loving ends of our soap molecules are bonding with that water and falling off our hands. And then what happens? Those little micelles fall off our hands, go down the drain, and it takes the coronavirus with it. And that's how soap kills the coronavirus.